see why you gotta show up looking so good just to hurt me. Why you wanna stop this whole damn world from turning?
He said a curse word.
Mercy.
Hey friends, welcome back to Aaron's Anxiety. I'm your host Aaron, your personal guide through anxiety. So, before we get started, you know it's coming. Hit that like button. It's right here. It's right here. It is. Hit that. other than that, hit the subscribe button. It's over there. And then I think the bell button is like here-ish? Here-ish? Maybe subscribe? Maybe here? do those things. Comment if you want to, you know, say hi or, you know, give me some pointers or tips or tricks or anything like that. And other than that, you can also join us on Facebook. We have the Aaron's Anxiety Family, which is a great place to get together and talk about our symptoms, side effects, and things like that. This is a solutions-based page made to help people. There's no trolls. Nobody, you know, it's going to be... We're all in the same boat. You know, somebody's going to make fun of you because we're all in the same boat or have been in the same boat. We're all trying to help each other in that boat to roar, to row to safety. So, check that out on Facebook. And also, I did want to bring up, and I've had a couple of people ask me about, I'm a very big proponent in that finances has a lot to do with your anxiety. And so one of the things that I use to help me save is an app called Acorns. You probably have heard of it before. It's been on the news. It's been all over. A lot of people use it. I think Steve Harvey had it on his show and talked about it. It's just an investment app, so it uses the spare change. When you use your debit card, it takes the spare change, rounds it up to the nearest dollar, and takes whatever change is left and invests that for you, and it adds up quickly. So the first year that I did it, I had $2,000 from roundups, and I think I had $10 a month that it would put into it. But I used my debit card a lot. And so that was money I ended up taking out, and I used, and it was great. I will leave a link in the description below. If you use my link, you will automatically get $5 to start. I get $5, you get $5. Everybody's winning. So check that out. I think you'll enjoy it if you're interested in helping that aspect of your life. All right, so today's video is about my anxiety. Who the fuck? So I got my Lexapro, okay? And I was out of Lexapro for about 3 days. And when I say I was out, I had Lexapro, okay? It's not the pharmacy's fault. I had it. But I left it at home. I always keep my pills in my truck because usually that's where I'm at throughout the week. And so this is where I take it. So I ran out in the truck. I had the pills at the house. Every time I was at the house, I kept forgetting to take the pill. And by the time I would remember, it was usually too late to take it. So, that being said, I got 3 days, a little over 3 days, without that pill. And I gotta say, it was different now that I've been on Lexapro for, like a year and a half now. Getting away from it is different than what it was before. So when I first started taking it, or even say the first 6 to 8 months of taking it, if I were to miss my pill and I were to not take my pill, I was feeling it that day. I was being drawn down. It felt foggy, felt closed down. My depersonalization was kind of would be spiked up, be more relevant. Just all those normal anxiety feelings, be worried, dwelling thoughts, and then I would just wait, and then the next day I would take the pill and it would feel better. Then once I got to be about 8 months in, I could skip a day. I could skip a day. And when I skipped a day, I felt fine. I didn't feel like overly exerted or anything like that. I just kind of picked it up the next day and just kind of kept rolling. And this was actually an experiment that I didn't want to do, but ended up doing anyway because of my procrastination and putting my pills back in my truck. So this time it was 3 days. 3 days. And I gotta say, 3 days in, day two was a breeze. Day two and a half, I was starting to feel something. Starting to feel a little bit more, like something's off. not that I'm feeling anxiety, but something's a little off. And then by the time that, by the time I woke up in the morning, it wasn't so bad. But around 10 o'clock, you know, say if I wake up at 9 or 8 o'clock or whatever, hang out with the baby. By the time I reach that 10 o'clock point where I normally take my pill, that's the 72-hour mark. That's when I was like, man, I kind of need this pill. I'm kind of feeling like I almost felt like I could feel the withdrawal of the substance in my body. But that was it was actually a very like relieving thing that I can go that far. I can go 72 hours without taking my pill, and it's not that big of a deal. Okay, like I wasn't, when I say that I was heightened, I wasn't like freaking out. Like, it was fine. I was fine. I just saw a cop. That's why I'm putting the seatbelt on. Because I always forget. Cops always have a way of making you remember. So to say that I felt stuff, it wasn't like the normal feeling stuff. It was still manageable. Like, I feel like I still could have went on. I think eventually, obviously, I would have went through some withdrawal. And I would have started having, like, brain zaps and heart palpitations and things like that. That's normal. That's why you want to wean yourself off when you come off. You don't want to go cold turkey. Dan and Shay, great, great band, but we're talking right now. so you definitely want to wean yourself off if you do that. That being said, it was very relieving to know that I could go that far. However, when I came back... Now, if you're on the Aaron's Anxiety Family page on the Facebook group, I appear there more than I do here on YouTube. And the reason is because it's easier for me to just go live, say what I'm thinking at that time, which is great because you get more updates and it's more of a real, hey, I have a great thought, and I don't have to sit down and make a video to do it. I can just go live, say my thought, be back into it. But when I came back to the pill, I took it, this was yesterday, and kind of like when you first start taking an SSRI in general, your anxiety will be exacerbated. It'll elevate a little bit, and you will feel a little bit worse before you start feeling better. I kind of had like a very small version of that yesterday. So I was feeling a little off, took the pill about 20 minutes later. I felt my anxiety was heightened a little bit. I felt a little bit more conscious of like what's going on with my body. Not that I was freaking out, because I don't want to portray that at all. Everything was definitely manageable. I was going to work, talking to people, everything was great. And if I was distracted talking to somebody, it wasn't a big deal at all. But that being said, that only lasted like 15 minutes maybe, and then it was back to the day. And then like today was day two back on my pill. It was like I never stopped. Okay, I was just right back into it. Took the pill same time, no problem. So this is a great example, though, and this is why I wanted to make this video, that when I first started taking this medication, I thought that I was going to be solely dependent on it. Like if I didn't have it at this exact time, that it was going to be a roller coaster, and that I would have anxiety, and I don't want to be that dependent on something constantly to be in my life, to be okay. And it's really refreshing to know that that's not the case, that I can get away from it for a while if I want to. And it does kind of reassure me that I think now, I'll have to talk with my doctor, but I think now I could probably come away from the medication, wean myself off, and I would probably be fine, because I have fixed several things in my life. That's the thing, when people talk about coming off, I always say make sure that you fix the big problems in your life, like your finances or your relationships or things like that. Get those things patched up. Get to a safe, secure spot. That way when you come off, that it doesn't come back, okay? Because you got to keep in mind, SSRIs, they're a mask. It's a band-aid. You're trying to make yourself, trying to make the world more palatable. So if you don't fix those things and you just come off, well, you know, 8-10 months down the road, you're going to be probably back in the same spot. So keep that in mind. All right, friends, I'm not going to go on too long with this video. I just wanted to get that out there, and I just wanted to say that if you are worried about that, it will be fine. You won't have that much of a dependency, and it's as weird as it sounds to say, when my anxiety was elevated a little bit, it was almost kind of like refreshing. I know that sounds really weird, and you guys are probably gonna blow up the comments on that one. But it was like, it's like, imagine that crappy friend that you have. And when I say that, like, it's a friend, like, you have your group of friends, and there's always that one friend that wants to hang out, but it's not really kind of kosher with the group. You're like, oh, this guy's here, darn it. But every now and then, you, like, miss that guy. You don't see him in a long time. You're like, hey, man, how you been? That was kind of like what it was when my anxiety came back for that 10, 15 minutes. I was like, hey, I remember this. This was, I mean, you got to keep in mind, this was, like, a while ago. This was at least 8 months ago that I've actually had those feelings. So I was like, hey, I remember this. Okay, all right, I remember this. But now it's a safe spot because I know it's going to go away. I know it's not here to stay. And that was the scariest part when this all took off. So there is a light at the end of the tunnel, friends. Life is good. It will be okay. You will get through this, I promise. If you go to the Aaron's Anxiety Family page, there are several people on there. I mean, 10, 12 people on there that when they first started with these videos or on there, they were in a dark place and they were very worried about they weren't going to get through it. And they got through it or are going through it enough to where they can see that they're going through it. And, like, you can just watch these people change. Like, their whole demeanor, how they react to things. If they have a bad day, they just like, oh, hey, well, today was a bad day. Obviously, tomorrow, you know, will probably be better. Whereas before, it's like, I think all days are going to be bad. You know what I mean? So you can watch people evolve on that page. It's really cool. So check that out. All right, friends, until next time, I'm Aaron. You're awesome. And I'll see you in the next video.